When young and up-and-coming fashion designer Balini Naidoo's uncle started gradually losing his eyesight, she noticed the difficulty he faced when it came to choosing clothing and the lack of options for people like him. This made Balini want to do something to help the visually impaired to become more self-reliant, as she explained.
For sighted people, fashion is something that is experienced mainly in visual terms, and we speak of a look without thinking twice. Designer Balini Naidoo knows exactly how to delight the eye, but her vision goes beyond the optics. Using cut, texture and innovation, she adds a touch of sophistication and elegance while also assuring everyday comfort.
Here on Mela, we aspire to inspire the trendsetters of tomorrow. Today, I'm really excited to meet Balini Naidoo, an upcoming fashion designer in Durban. She's going to take us on her fashion journey and give us a sneak peek at a showstopper for her wedding day.
Balini holds a Bachelor of Technology degree in Fashion and Textile Design, and she's also a professional model.
Hi Balini, how are you?
I'm good, thanks, and you?
I'm good. When did you discover that you had a passion for fashion?
From a very young age, I used to be very creative and dress up as a young kid and putting things together, and I used to be very fussy. My parents used to get very irritated at me being fussy in what to wear and what not to wear.
Where do you draw your inspiration from?
I draw a lot of inspiration from architecture and the surroundings around me, and as well as people that influenced me along the way.
Working in the fashion industry is no walk in the park. How do you build your craft?
I keep myself updated on current trends and social media. I watch a lot of fashion TV. I follow a lot of prominent designers, as well as I have my own unique style as well. And keeping as a designer, you have to have your own unique style. I love working with fabrics like knits and heavyweight fabrics and creating different textures. So putting all that together, that creates my own craft and my unique style.
You've actually pioneered a new concept. Can you tell me more about it?
I came up with this concept of designing a Braille identification system which assists visually impaired people identify clothing in terms of colour, size, style description, and as well as a wash care label.
What made you come up with this design concept?
I did have an uncle who was visually impaired, which really motivated me, but I really have a passion for people with disabilities and those that are less fortunate, so I said, why can't I use my skill and my craft to help others out there. So I then developed this concept of mine from my first year of studying and then elaborated on it in my BTEC study.
This sounds fantastic. I would love to see it.
I actually do have some designs here that I can show you.
Combining clean lines with a minimalist approach, Balini's range has everything you'd expect from contemporary street style, but there's more to it than meets the eye.
So this is what I was talking about, my range. This is one of the garments that I've designed. I kept the palette very neutral, so that helps visually impaired people to pair their garments together. The Braille system says the color of the garment, the size, the wash care labels, as well as the style description. The jacket is reversible, so it can be worn anywhere around. Being visually impaired, they don't really have to worry which side they're wearing the jacket or not. I've also designed a graphic print on this jacket, a menswear jacket. Instead of using circles for Braille, I've used squares and just pushed it more innovative and created a repeat print of a hidden message. So this basically just says lost in translation, and it's repeated all over the garments, just creating something more appealing for visually impaired people.
Balini, what are some of your basic fashion do's and don'ts?
Personally, I love monotone colors and very earthy colors, which you can see in my range, as well as the big trend is matching big bold prints, which I think that if you take a color in the bold print and then match it with either the top or the pants, or if you're bold enough to match two prints together to make a fashion statement, that could also work.
What is your philosophy in life?
I believe strongly by this quote where what you do for yourself dies with you, but what you do for others lasts a lifetime. Creating a legacy that can be left behind for generations to come.
Now I know you have a special day coming up.
Yes, I am getting married soon, and I have designed my own wedding dress, and I would love to show you.
I'd love to see it.
Balini has established a reputation for being a versatile and inventive designer. So Madhushan didn't know quite what to expect, but she wasn't about to disappoint him.
Wow, you look fantastic.
Thank you.
How did you come up with this design?
I always wanted to design a dress that was more fitted and that represented me, that was more unique. So I worked around that and designed a dress that was unique, simple, and I love floral prints, and so that's what you can see with my beadwork.
Balini, on behalf of Mela, we wish you all the best for your future career and have a blissful wedded life.
Thank you.
Balini has since tied the knot with Brent Engelbrecht, and the wedding was held in the fishing village of Veldrift on the west coast. We're sure you'll agree that she made a stunning bride and that he's a very lucky man.